Welcome to the second video on the meaning, concept, general types of pedagogical techniques and strategies. This video, as already told to you, would enlighten you on the pedagogical framework and types of pedagogical practices pertinent to early childhood education. At the end of this video, you will be able to compare and contrast the pedagogical framework in early childhood education, state the pedagogical techniques and strategies employed in the early classroom setting. For a child to develop as a confident, competent, and powerful individuals, needed stimulation and experiences have to be provided at a younger age. It's an age when the brain is easily moldable. Each child is born with powerful motivations and dispositions to learn and can be an active agent in the society with their motivations kept at a higher level, but with appropriate cognitive and social interactions. Hence, a facilitator or educator engaged with the young minds should be well informed about the child development perspectives, should possess positive attitude and interest in children, should consider play as a powerful tool in a child's learning, and should understand the interrelationship and the intra-relationship context of the child. And to identify the real and meaningful learning context is much needed. The pedagogy of early childhood education is of two types, as already specified to you in the other video. It is based on the person who initiates the experiences. Either it is teacher-centered or child-centered. Now let us compare and contrast the two pedagogical approaches within certain concepts. The first concept is on the theoretical assumption. The teacher-centered approach has got the assumption that a child learns concepts or skills only in sequence. Whereas the child-centric approach has got an assumption that a child gains knowledge or skill by exploring, interacting, and experiencing the environment on their own. And with reference to the framework, the teacher-centric is a structured framework, whereas the learning-centric takes up an open framework. Looking into the approach, the teacher-centric learning or teaching is highly adult or teacher-directed and it is primarily informative. Whereas the approach for the child-centered is entirely becoming a learner or child-directed and it is largely experiential. Now, what's the role of the teacher in teacher-centered approach? The teacher should take the lead by providing explicit information. Whereas in child-centered approach, the teacher should respond to the interests and needs of the child, should organize the environment and materials to provide a basket of learning opportunities for the child to choose on his own, observe and interact with children to provide the needed support, document evidence of improvement in learning and development potential of the child, and then interpret the evidence and arrive at an effective strategy or solution. Now, what's the role of the child in the teacher-centered approach? The child only should actively engage without distraction. But in a learner-centric, the child has got the liberty to choose one learning opportunity from the basket at a time based on his own interest. Now let us look into some of the practice examples in teacher-centered approach. It's only about giving direct or explicit instruction. Modeling can be done, demonstrating also can be done. Whereas in child-centered approach, it is all about co-constructing, questioning with constructive feedback, and providing cues or hints for assistance. What would be the learning outcome out of the teacher-centered approach? It's all about the knowledge or skill acquisition that can be directly measured. But whereas in child-centered approach, the child's independence, social and emotional development, creativity, and self-expressions are the outcomes, but that cannot be directly measured. The major strategies identified by National Youth Access Initiative in their professional pedagogy project are listed and defined to you. First practice is positioning. As a teaching strategy, positioning refers to careful, logical placement of learning materials in relation to objects or concepts and in relation to people. The second strategy is empowering. It is a technique that guides and helps children to gain a sense of inner confidence and courage by making them believe that they are powerful. The third, it's a very important strategy, what we call it as a vital pedagogical strategy. It is coined by Vygotsky and developed by Bruner. It is a process by which a child is temporarily guided or supported by an adult in accomplishing a task which otherwise the child would not have accomplished. The fourth pedagogy is about the co-constructing. It refers to the process of collaborative interaction between the child and the educator through which knowledge is built on a concept. The fifth is very important strategy, what we call it as modeling. It's a process by which an educator acts as a model of displaying or demonstrating a behavior or a skill or attitude so that the child imitates the same. Sixth strategy is questioning. It is a very useful pedagogical technique as children in their early years use questions as a pathway to communicate with others. Open-ended questions would be more effective in ECE pedagogy. Seventh is encouraging and acknowledging. It is a process of providing positive verbal or non-verbal attention to the child, thereby enhancing the child's self-esteem. Eighth strategy is about the problem solving. As a teaching strategy, the problem solving technique adopted by an educator helps children to find solutions to day-to-day problems, confusions, and challenges that they face. Ninth pedagogical technique is about documenting. It's a process of gradually building a unique and lively picture of the child as a whole over some time across the range of learning experiences and at varied context. The pedagogical framework are approaches that have been derived from the key principles put forth by pedagogues with particular reference to early childhood education had clearly stated that the provisions in ECE stating. Moreover, a prelude of the 9 most effective pedagogical technique is listed to you, and further modules would describe the process of each pedagogy in detail. Hope to meet you with the content of the next week. Thank you.